In this lesson, we'll determine the angle of intersection of two curves using vectors. The curves f of x equals x squared minus 4x plus 4 and g of x equals 3x plus 4 intersect at the point 0 comma 4 as shown below. Find the angle of intersection in radians on the interval from 0 to pi, close on 0, open on pi, and we're told to round to two decimal places. To find the angle of intersection, we'll determine the slopes of the tangent lines at the point of intersection, and then we'll use those slopes to form two vectors, and then we'll use the formula below to determine the angle between two vectors. Let's begin by determining the derivatives. F prime of x is equal to the derivative of x squared minus 4x plus 4, which is 2x minus 4, and g prime of x equals the derivative of 3x plus 4, which is 3. And now to determine the derivative function values at the point of intersection, or at x equals 0. F prime of 0 equals 2 times 0 minus 4, or negative 4. And g prime of 0 equals 3. This indicates the slope of the tangent line to f of x at the point of intersection is negative 4, and the slope of the tangent line at the point of intersection for g of x is positive 3. Let's go ahead and sketch the tangent lines to both f of x and g of x. Well, first notice because g of x is a line, the tangent line is going to be the same line. Let's sketch the tangent line to the parabola, or the tangent line to f of x at the point of intersection. We know the slope is negative 4, or if we want negative 4 divided by 1. To find additional points to the tangent line to f of x at the point of intersection, starting at the point of intersection, we can go down 4 units and right 1 unit, or if we want from the point of intersection and go up 4 units and left 1 unit. This red line is the tangent line to the parabola at the point of intersection. The angle of intersection is the same as the angle between the two tangent lines, but notice there are two angles of intersection. We have an obtuse angle here, as well as an acute angle here. We'll be determining both angles of intersection. To find the angle of intersection, we'll now form two vectors that have the same slope as f prime of 0 and g prime of 0. Because f prime of 0 equals negative 4, or negative 4 divided by 1, we can form a vector that has the same slope by starting at the point of intersection and then going down 4 units and right 1 unit. This vector, which we'll call vector v, has a slope of negative 4, the same slope as the tangent line to f of x at the point 0, comma 4. And now we'll form a vector with a slope of positive 3, or if we want positive 3 divided by 1. To do this, we can start at the point of intersection and then move up 3 units and right 1 unit, and we'll call this vector vector w. Again, notice this vector does have a slope of 3, which is the same slope as the tangent line to g of x at the point of intersection. And now let's write vector v and w in component form. Vector v has a slope of negative 4, or negative 4 divided by 1. Going back to the coordinate plane, notice this indicates that the x component is equal to positive 1, and the y component is equal to negative 4. Notice the y component divided by the x component is equal to the slope of negative 4. And now for vector w, which we know has a slope of positive 3, going back to the coordinate plane, has an x component of 1 and a y component of positive 3. Again, notice the y component divided by the x component equals the slope of positive 3. And now we can determine the angle of intersection, or both angles of intersection, using the formula cosine theta equals the dot product of vectors v and w divided by the product of their magnitudes. This gives us cosine theta is equal to, again, the dot product of vector v and w divided by the product of their magnitudes. This gives us cosine theta equals, the dot product is 1 times 1 plus negative 4 times 3 divided by the product of their magnitudes. The magnitude of vector v equals the square root of the sum of the square of 1 and the square of negative 4, and the magnitude of vector w equals the square root of the sum of 1 and the square of 3. Simplifying, 1 plus negative 12 is negative 11. In the denominator, we have the square root of 17 times the square root of 10. So if we know that cosine theta equals negative 11 divided by the product of the square root of 17 and the square root of 10, we can take the inverse cosine of both sides of the equation and write the equation as theta equals inverse cosine of negative 11 divided by the product of the square root of 17 and the square root of 10. And now we grab the calculator. To begin, it's important to make sure the calculator is in radian mode, which we can see it is. For the inverse cosine function, click Show Keypad, click Functions, and we have the inverse trig functions here. I've already entered the expression. To two decimal places, we have approximately 2.57. Let's go ahead and call this theta sub 1. Going back to the coordinate plane, this is the obtuse angle of intersection, which is this angle of intersection here. To find the acute angle of intersection, because the two angles are supplementary, we subtract 2.57 from pi. So we'll call theta sub 2 is going to be approximately pi minus 2.57 radians, which you may have already seen on the calculator, is 0.57. So you may be asked to find either the acute or obtuse angle of intersection, or you may be asked to find both. I hope you found this helpful.